inappropriate relationship or more than one inappropriate relationship, according to the allegation. Let's put the picture up full mast. She's married to a police officer. Emma Delaney Hancock, a former substitute teacher at Wellston Public Schools, turned herself in on Thursday because of allegations that she had an inappropriate sexual relationship with a 15-year-old student. She then posted a $50,000 bond and was immediately released. So let's go to photos of Hancock and her husband. So Ms. Hancock is married to that fella. She's the wife of Wellston Police Chief Alfred Hancock and the daughter of the town's mayor, Paul E. Whitner. The case is reportedly being handled by the Oklahoma State Bureau of Investigation to avoid any conflict of interest. Let me go to the affidavit. According to the affidavit filed in Lincoln County Circuit, an OSBI investigator interviewed the 15-year-old student who allegedly had an inappropriate relationship with Ms. Hancock. Ms. Hancock began texting this child in October to send him a school assignment. The affidavit said, after a few weeks, the teen allegedly sent a shirtless photo of himself to Ms. Hancock through Snapchat. The affidavit said Ms. Hancock responded, "Are we sending half-naked pictures now?" "I don't know, are we?" the teen responded. "Are you trying to get me to lose my job?" Ms. Hancock wrote back, according to the affidavit. The document said Ms. Hancock and the teen later began exchanging nude photos and nude videos of sex acts. This escalated into Ms. Hancock and the teen kissing each other on their mouths on two occasions while in classrooms. Ms. Hancock also touched the teen inappropriately during the second time they kissed. According to the court filing, Ms. Hancock was facing two counts of soliciting sexual conduct or communication with minors by use of technology and two counts of lewd and indecent acts to a child under 16 years of age. Let's put up the superintendent. Buck stops with him. Wellstone, public school superintendent Mike Franz said as soon as the district learned about the allegations in November, Hancock was removed from the call list and is no longer going to be a teacher working on the campus. All right. And they are, in fact, cooperating with the investigation. OK, you see, these are real issues. Lawmakers, Republican lawmakers in particular, they're not going to make it a thing because they want you to think critical race theory is really what's going down. Okay. The reality is there's a problem here. There's a problem. When we had bullying in the schools, and we still have it, we saw that as a problem. What happened? We had a full and funded campaign to come after bullying. We called it the anti-bullying campaign. A whole lot of money, a whole lot of emphasis, right? They decided not to include racism in that, by the way, but I digress. Now you have school teachers, once again, reports are coming every week. What are we going to do? Where's the emphasis? Where's the focus? Even if there's no change in legislative dynamic, there should be a change at least in how we attack and approach such a detrimental issue inside of the school system. These children are adversely impacted even if you may not be able to see the signs today. This is a violation of trust at a level that they cannot comprehend in the moment, but it plays out over the course of their journey. It is a shame we have these monsters working among our children. Sharon, thoughts on this?
Got to be dealt with. And I look for Jim Jordan to take his committee on the road to Oklahoma, and perhaps he can study predators and deal with this. But it's a very serious issue. And if you care about children, this will be stopped, hard stop.
Yep. We'll see what happens. Naturally, I don't expect any legislation to come from this. But for those who have been adversely affected, we do hope that they get the help they deserve.